In this video lecture, we're going to take a quick look at the four basic computing flows of control in programs. This will serve as both a short recap of what we've covered to this point and an overview of where we'll be going in the next few weeks of lecture. Okay, let's get started. As a quick refresher, a flow of control in computing simply represents the generalized path of execution of the instructions in any program. There are four basic flows of control in programming, two of which we've already seen, and two more which we'll be covering next. First, there is sequential execution, in which a series of instructions is simply executed in some ordered, linear fashion. The required main method of all the code we've examined and written for ourselves is a prime example of this control flow. Next, there is the method call, in which the path of execution jumps to some other method, which is fully evaluated, and then perhaps some resulting value is returned to the same point in the original path of execution. As we've seen, this is useful in the structuring of programs because it lets us carve out repeated sets of instructions into their own dedicated named program unit. Instantiating new program objects and then calling their available API methods are a typical example we've already seen of this type of control flow. There are two additional computing flows of control, and these will be the subject of discussion for us in the coming few weeks. First, there is selection, which represents some logical fork in the road, in which we must decide which path to take according to some program logic. And finally, there is looping, in which we will execute some common body of instructions repeatedly, either for a specified number of times, or else until some logical condition is met. Note the word logic in both of these descriptions. Both these last two flows of control represent logic, or decision making, in programs. And this is where programming really starts to become fun, because finally we can start designing some smarts into our programs. Let's take a quick look at these four flows of control visually. Here we see a nice summary comparison of the four basic flows of control in programming. As an aside, these types of visual depictions are known as flowcharts in programming, and these are very simplified, generalized models. There's that word again, models, of actual program flow. As we've just said, we've already looked at these first two. Sequential execution is just a straight line execution path through some set of program instructions. Method calls represent a temporary pause in the execution path while we jump somewhere else in program memory, make some computations, perhaps return some result, and then resume execution right where we left off. The selection and looping control flows, by contrast, represent alternative paths through the flow of execution. Furthermore, we don't know until runtime what the exact path through our program will be. It all depends on the outcome of the decision making we've incorporated into our program logic. If you look at these last two flows of control, you may notice that they have one thing in common, and that's this blue diamond in both flows of control. In software flowcharts, a diamond such as this represents a condition, which is simply a decision point or a fork in the road. Conditions allow us to express simple yes-no questions whose outcome tells us what will happen next. So, before we cover selection and looping in upcoming lecture materials, we need to first understand how to create and express such conditions. And that gives us a nice segue into our next two topics, which will be conditions and the conditional operators with which we can express them.